Knowing the difference between concepts, models, and theories will help you understand research and communicate intelligently with other professionals. There are a number of ways to define concepts. Essentially, a concept is a description of an event, situation, or experience. Typically, these descriptions of concepts are abstract and complex. Some concepts are more understood than others. It is important to define concepts so we can communicate. For example, my husband and I have different views on what defines a garage and a shed. Since we own properties with both, our different definitions have caused some communication issues. When I talk about needing to clean the garage, sometimes the wrong building gets cleaned. Research studies should present a conceptual or theoretical framework in the introduction portion of the article. These frameworks tell you where the researcher is coming from and define the concepts under study. It helps to know how a researcher views the concepts under study so you can determine if you, or other studies you are looking at, define these concepts in the same way. That way you know if they are studying a shed or a garage. Sometimes, researchers will describe what is known about the concepts without a model or a theory. In this case, it is called a conceptual framework. Other times, they will present a specific model or theory to describe how the concepts that they will be studying relate to one another. However, before models and theories can be developed, concepts need to be defined. There are specific methods to define concepts for research. The methods chosen will depend on your beliefs about the nature of the concept. If you believe concepts are concrete, measurable, and do not change, your approach will search for the truth about the concepts. Concepts that are defined in this way may be the variables under study in quantitative research. However, if you think that concepts are influenced by context, recognizable but not measurable, and dynamic, your approach would be much different. Concepts that are defined in this way would be more congruent as a framework for qualitative research. To find out more about how concepts are developed, please visit the video on your screen. Often, research will examine the relationships between and among various concepts. A framework that shows these relationships may be in the form of a model or a theory. Models are usually developed based on qualitative research. They demonstrate the researcher's interpretation of how concepts are related to one another. You may find models in the findings section of some research articles. Sometimes, models are based on understandings that are not from specific research studies. For example, the picture on this slide represents a model of my understanding of the difference between concepts, models, and theories. Theories, on the other hand, are more tested than models. They are systematic and are used to explain, predict, describe, and prescribe phenomena. They look a lot like models, so sometimes people confuse these two terms. Theories are tested and measured, most of the time with quantitative research, in order to prove the relationships between concepts. It takes a lot more than one research study to prove a theory. Qualitative research can also be done to support theories. The more research that supports a theory, the better it is. Remember, concepts need to be defined in order to build a model or a theory. Both models and theories show proposed relationships between concepts. The difference between a model and a theory is the amount of proof that exists for them, which stems from how they were developed. Models are not considered proven. Theories are considered proven and supported by multiple research studies. That is why they are viewed as a more systematic representation of phenomena. For more information, please visit the videos on this slide and subscribe. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful.